Hi everybody. This is my name is Önder Turacı. I'm the co-founder and managing partner of D4 Digital Solutions. Today I will try to present you about what we do and an ongoing project which is about end-to-end steel coil tracking of our customers. Maybe first, I just make a quick presentation of our company and a brief introduction of our what we do and our products, etc., and what we are doing together with WirePress. Let me share my screen. Yeah, a little introduction about D4. D4 has been founded in 2017.
Sorry, Ander, we cannot see your screen.
Just a minute. I just share it. Is it okay now?
Yes.
It's a little bit delay.
It's okay now.
Okay. Okay, sorry. D4 has been founded in 2017 with the vision of becoming a leading system integrator company of Industry 4.0 solutions in Turkey. Our first initial starting was being a systems integrator company to help companies digital transformation. For this, we were trying to provide consultancy and project implementation and software development in IoT and RTLS areas. And because of that, and if you look at our name, it's D4. D stands for digital for the industry, and 4 is stands for Industry 4.0. So we were aiming to implement digital projects with the global partnerships, but in time, actually. We see that there are a lot of project requirements, specific project requirements of the customers on the field. So we added product development capabilities so that we can cover the these specific project requirements and problems on the field. In 2018, our roads crossed with WirePress. Our first initial use case was to enrich our RTLS portfolio to create some alternative solutions for the project needs. This was our first starting with WirePress, but then we understood that it was a technology we can use in many areas for creating innovative and effective solutions, actually. The most attractive topic for us was the mesh and the low energy concepts. And without infrastructure, too much infrastructure, we can implement many things on the field. So there were unlimited use cases. Then we started development and test phase for many products and ideas with different use cases. And after the evaluation period, and it was a long period. In the meantime, we developed a lot of prototypes and things. Then, after all, we developed several products in our different focus areas. D4 has two main focus areas. One is in industrial area. I'm coming from actually industrial area, and the other topic we have is the smart building and facility management area. For the industrial area, we have our industrial asset tags and several sensors and readers to track assets or things in the environment, in the factory environment. Several of them are our industrial tag, which you can see in the picture below, the asset reader, the load sensor with strain gauge, which is actually a sensor which can sense the load. For example, we use these on cranes or forklifts. Then we can understand when the crane or the forklift is carrying an asset, or we can even get the weight of it, actually. Then we have the distance magnetic sensors for exact positioning of the of some devices on the field, maybe some machines or some part of the machine. And we developed a surface temperature sensor for steel industry. It is a wireless sensor tag with surface temperature sensor on it, and it can be used in mesh for reading or tracking the temperatures of the coils inside the stock area after the annealing and cooling phase of the process. And there are a lot coming. We are developing these things according to the requirements of the customers on the field, in the project. And on the smart building side, several of our products are people counters, which is a counter counting the passage through doors to inside or outside. We can differentiate the direction of the passage, actually. Door counter is a classic magnetic Hall effect sensor. Service need button for using the meeting rooms or maybe toilets to make people to give information about the service need of the area. And we have material sensors to track the material levels in some environments, like again toilets, toilet papers, or different kind of materials, and also ambient sensors, which are for especially meeting rooms or office environments. There is a carbon dioxide sensor, temperature, humidity sensors. Also, we have it's not written here, but we also have energy control modules, which are linked with our motion sensors, and we can control the energy or lighting of the meeting room or of the environment according to the presence inside the room, or we can make connection with the meeting room schedule or anything it can be connected. You can control it from the central room, etc. And lately, very popular now, we prototyped as the social distancing sensor, which detects the approach of people to each other. It records the data and sends it when it joins to the Wirepass network in any place. Or if you like, you can develop a software or get the data from the advertisement data with a mobile phone. These are the products which we are we can provide. Actually, we developed them for our need, but now we are providing these devices to any partners or any who want to use these devices. And coming to do this topic, today's topic is steel coil end-to-end tracking. Now we are on an ongoing phase of this project. We finished some of the lines. It's a multinational steel producer company in Turkey. It's the area is around 250k square meter. And it's about inventory tracking of the steel coils and sheets, starting from the entry of the raw material to the site and shipment of the finished product to the customer. This is really a big project with nearly 30,000 asset tags and supporting IoT devices and 30 plus cranes and forklifts are equipped with our IoT devices. And the in this project, we are focusing on location tracking of the coils. It's not a rough location tracking. Mainly, the coils are being tracked at exact locations which they are put, and automatic inventory counting and distance, the work order management for the production and process automation of some processes. Actually, when you put the coil to a track, it is automatically going out of the stock or going on the track. And when the track is out of the stockyard and at the scale, it's the shipment is process is completed, etc. There are a lot of process automation things which brings time saving to our customers. In this, we are using asset tags, load sensors, distance sensors, truck tags, readers, all in Wirepass mesh network. So this was my all slides about the this presentation, but I have a video animation which is actually showing what we are doing right now in this project, and I will tell about go through this here. Yeah. Can you see the videos there?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. And this is just an example site modeling which in which the coils are stacked in many different styles. It differs from material to material. And for all these different kind of stocking, we are introducing different kind of solutions. We have to introduce different kind of solutions. But in every one, as you see, there is a tag attached to the coils. This is our asset tag, and it is attached to a coil at the end of a production line or at the end of the packaging line, or it is taken out at the end of the line, so it is recycled throughout all the production or shipment process. And this pairing is very critical, because if you don't pair an asset with the tag, then you lose its track. So there are some rules. When a crane, for example, takes the coil from the production to the stockyard, we have rules for that. So our asset tags have sensors inside, and these all are working in low latency, low energy network, and this is forming a wireless mesh IoT network on the field. We have some gateways on the walls, and with this, very basically, we are doing inventory counting in many, several ways. Actually, we can send commands to the coils, and we get some responses. There are several ways for this, and inventory counting is a very effective way in this project. And for tracking the position of the coils, all the coils are being carried either by cranes or forklifts. For the cranes, we have some readers on the crane rails, or in X or Y direction. We can understand where the coil is being taken, or where it will be put. There is a work order management site. We get this from the SAP system, and we integrate it to the crane system. You can visually see the stockyard, and you can see which coil you should take and where you should put it. So either in the stockyard or on a if it's a, for example, shipment order, then you put it on the truck loading area on a truck, so you can see where you should put it, and you can control if you are putting it on the right place or not. In this way, there is no wrong shipment or wrong placement of the coils. Later phase of the project will be optimizing this area. And for the forklifts, it's again, we have some IoT devices on the forklifts. Maybe I missed to tell here on the cranes, we have some readers and some sensors on the crane. When there is a motion on a coil, we can understand there is a connection between the sensor and the IoT device. But we also have some specific algorithms to differentiate different accelerated materials, because in the area there are some unwanted accelerations of other coils. So we have to filter them. And then we have the load sensor. When you take the coil, it can understand it really is taking a coil, not any other thing, because with the load sensor, we can actually get the weight of that coil on the crane. It's a rough weight, but it's not too much. There is not too much fluctuation from the real tonnage. So we can understand that it's a very crucial part of this project. So this is what I would like to explain. And then coming to the forklift side, we also have some readers and also, again, a load sensor to understand if it is taking a coil or any other thing. Our asset tag is a battery-operated tag, which has an accelerometer on it, an LED on it for peak-to-light operations. For the forklift operation, to find the steel sheets, because the steel sheets are stacked on top of each other and they are very close to each other, it's not easy to differentiate the exact location of it. We narrow the location with our IoT devices, but when a forklift operator takes over the work order, it goes to the area where the coil actually is, and when he goes to the place, the peak to light with the peak to light functionality, he can see the steel sheet blinking, the tag of the steel sheet blinking to understand which material he should take. And for the we can send specific configuration commands for the for example the accelerometer. We can configure its threshold or the duration of the acceleration, or you can select the axis of the acceleration. You can configure them. For the LED also, you can configure the times and etc. And also we have we can also put the memory memory inside if there is a need for writing on it. And also the we have the magnet inside the tag. And in this project, we do the tag product pairing. We track the inventory movements. We manage the production or shipment work orders. We do inventory count. We cover the shipment process from a truck coming to the site and going to the loading area and then going back to the gates, and then the process finished. Also, we have product search and find capabilities so that in any case you lose the place of a product, you can send command to the product you search, and you can make a bypass search, bypass scan of the area, and you can find the place of the coil from the coils with known locations. So it's a good functionality. And that's what we do in this project.